summary drill of some of the stuff we've done from Pinan Sandan kata. It doesn't cover the entirety of the drill, but it's not the entirety of the kata, but it's not far off. Okay, and again, these aren't substitutes for live practice or drilling the bunkai individually. You should do that too. These are just nice, time-efficient ways to practice lots of bunkai in a short period of time. So it's part of a mix of training. We start off with the arm up, and the arm can be anything. It can be a push, a shove, a flinch, doesn't matter. Just got an arm up. And we were using Marotte Moshiyuki as an entry. So we're going to be moving through to here. Once we've got that position, we're circling the arm round as I start to move to the side. So the movement sideways in the kata, because that's telling us we need to be at the enemy's side. So I go from there, circle. And then let this arm continue as it passes towards the other hand. So that's how I get my sideways position. So that was the entry practice. Once I've got that, I'm to the side, this arm then comes down, this one comes up. So that's my first crack as I attack the back of the arm. Following the kata, I then step in, so I'm raising my body weight up, switch the arms over, then switch them back. So that would be from there, step in, switch the arms over, then switch them back. So I'm smashing it right through. Hopefully we get some injury on that, at the very least it'll get it to move up a little bit. I can take it down, it's better to take it over the top of your head on the next move because the pain's coming from underneath. So his natural direction is to take it forward, being that part of the kata. So I've gone from there. I then move in, take hold the back of the arm and do the nuki-te. The nuki-te being the slam across the chest. Then you do a winding throw, which I'll just show so they've got it. Right? So I take the back foot round, turn from there, that brings him down on an impact. But, for the sake of our big drill, he just throws his weight into it. So as I got through the throat, boom, so I just feel, okay, I'm not going to get big. So I gather back in. You can then add in some little bits of dirt at that point if you like. I extend this arm as I impact. And then I'm taking the next part of the cap is this bit. I'm taking the headlock in. Both arms on the back of the triceps. I step away from him and throw my hip in. So I'm doing a cross button, so it's on the show first, then we can counter it, yeah? So I'm stepping into here and then rolling him over that way. For the sake of the drill, exactly what happened there is he puts a hand on my hip, so as I go to it, he kills it. And that'll mean he'll come around the side of it like this. Okay, he'll hop round. Like the kata does before the end two movements is a punch. So I release my arm, I pull the hand back, and I impact. Being the junzuki that appears later in the kata. For the sake of the drill, rather than just go straight for the final throw, I'm going to put an extra grip in. So I'm going to go with this hand under here, and I'm going to wrestle around and grab his far hip. Just turn so you can all see. When I do that, I need my hips low, so he can't throw me. Ideally, I want my thigh against the back of his thigh, and I want my head up. If my head drops down here, he can bring his arm over, he'll get me in a headlock himself. If I'm there and he tries to do that, again, it's hard work, I can counter it. At least for a moment, anyway. I'll then take this leg in front, throw myself right the way through from there, and just do a basic hip throw. Roll him over, he lands on the floor, I impact, and I move away. And we did talk about what you can do if he falls with you, but that's not really part of the drill. So I'll just do one more straight walkthrough, if that's all right. So the arm is up, redirect, one, two. Take the arm off the side, slam it, he leans in. Gather back up, some extra dirt, gather here. He puts a hand on my hip, he counters it, he comes down, bang. Move from here, get his grip, in with the hip. Take him over, impact, move away, look for the next guy. And that's our Sandan drill. Okay.